Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rafe Gal. We are gonna jump in here with Lufia 2. We're gonna see if we can wrap up a few of the remaining areas today. I believe we have to go talk to the Elder. There we go. Queen of Primeril. Crescent-shaped island under the sea. And he has proof. It's jade from the island. So, we get to go under the sea. No musical interlude necessary. But before that, we are going to take a quick detour. If I can remember. Let's see, is this? No. Actually, this one might be. So, let's see if this is right. This is it. Okay. So we're gonna do a quick grind session here. You may recognize all of these enemies as things we fought before that drop fruit. I totally forgot that this island was right here this whole time and full of enemies that drop those items. I'm not sure if this one in particular has all of them or if they have different ones, because there's several islands throughout the world. If we don't see the right enemies for Dark Fruit pretty soon, we're not going to bother, because I'm just seeing the four elemental ones right now. We definitely don't need the levels right now. There we go. We're just gonna bust Bryo because it's really powerful. We want to get through these fights quickly. Dark Fruit right off the bat. Awesome. That means we can level Flash up, which is our last M class here. I think Flash is on the last form. No. Two. We go from the fairy to a unicorn. So Flash is actually decent in this final form. You can see his attack just took a huge jump. And he should get his healing stuff back. Let's go with, let's double check here real quick. I can't even bring myself to use Zeppy. You know what, we're gonna go with, let's go Gusto for a little bit. Flash is the highest level currently, and I don't really... I'm just gonna try and kind of round it out so we can use a couple different ones as the game goes on. Also, this next section is not super long or hard that I'm recalling. Crescent-shaped island. Submarine cave. I think we wandered over here once earlier. That gate only opens if you have the jade. There's an inn. There's some people wondering why we're here. There's a temple. Let's see if there's anything worthwhile here. So this light guard is okay, but if I'm remembering right, it's not used. It doesn't come up very often. Interesting dialogue from the mermaids there. Head up and talk to the queen. Oh, the Elder Enchade, how's he doing? Oh, dual blade? Oh, okay. Submarine Shrine. This may be Dual Blade. North of here, there's three islands in a circle. Turned around the cave connected to the shrine has changed. Once you're in, it's impossible to go back. Princess Piera likes to go swim around the caves. She's totally going to the cave. So this is totally meant to be just the Dual Blade quest, and then it's like suddenly turns into, oh hey, there's also family stuff and more randomness going on. Like I said a couple times now, they kind of insert that kind of stuff into a lot of these. Just double checking we can't get through those. You have to Submarine Shrine. And we get a boss fight. Ghost ship right off the bat. Like I said, this is a pretty short section. We're just gonna nuke the crap out of it and hope that that does it. A little bit more magic as the game goes on. It becomes a lot more relevant. I Looks like fire is its weakness, so we'll just nuke it with Firebird twice. Or it's weak to Holy and Fire, and Artie's just way weaker than Selen. Kind of weird boss. It's not like it's super hard, but a lot of the enemies that it summons are actually really nasty if you let them live. Apparently Artie does just as much using his sword, so we'll just go with that. That was totally an accident, but whatever. Racism! The current! Something else was going on. Okay. And we get to meet another Sinistral. Who just murders a bunch of, they talk about who gave them the powers, who chose them. So, this is the first time I've actually seen this particular area. Normally it's super glitched out. I'm gonna wander around a little bit. Normally you just hold forward and push A and pray. And we get to Dual Blade. Dual Blade is ringing. Doesn't ring one guy, does it? Maxim's the one who has to do it. So Eric had told me of it. I had to see a human making Dual Blade ring. And we meet our antagonist, Deus. Thank you. and they get teleported out. Only to see an island floating in the sky. Understand how powerless you really are? If you want to fight, fight us. Only a coward attacks powerless innocent people. If you have something to say, come up here and we'll talk then. What can we do? Take a guess. We're gonna go to Portravia. Doom Island. I thought it better to give it a name, so I came up with Doom Island. Okay. So he needs a better engine. Can't make it right now, so we're gonna go steal it from Grazie Kingdom. Throw it without permission. Okay. This is one of the other caves that we came across earlier. And I think it's actually that one over there. Okay, we're gonna try going around here. So I saw a cave opening through here. It's a bit out of the way, but might be it. Go the same place. Why would you block off one? Grazie, there we go. So this takes us back to the bottom of this dungeon where we were chasing the Ruby icon. And straight into Grazie Kingdom. And we just immediately get attacked. And put to sleep, because apparently drowsy is the best spell ever. And our best buds are here. So Bertie and Bart are going to get rid of these soldiers for us, or are going to get rid of the door for us, and we're going to get rid of the soldiers. So we're going to get to fight 4 soldiers. So they're all dead. Really don't care about fighting stuff in this for the most part. I'll do a few just to get them out of the way. But generally speaking, not gonna be too worried about it. Sphinxes get 2 actions, they can do status effects and stuff, but they're kind of annoying. But there's way worse enemies in the game. Get the key. Okay. Mm-hmm. Hey, White Dragon. So we could wreck these guys, but again, we don't really need to. That's one of those random puzzles that just kind of comes out of nowhere. Shooting the eye. You didn't happen to think of it? Strafko and the eye, Wormeyes. Okay, I missed like two whole rooms worth of stuff. Looks like I'm stuck. Can't go back. Okay. If it lets me back in, I will. Magical Selen, you're going to pay for it now! Okay, we get to fight four more soldiers, which... I don't think we're even gonna bother with. See which of these works best. They took about 150 damage each from the spells last time. That was ice and fire. Less from that. More from that. So thunder is currently the best. Or just hit them. And now we get to fight the tank. This whole section is just kind of silly. Thanks, Flash. Okay, Let's do a little experimenting. Probably just do physicals, but whatever. Bribe's a little better. And let's see if Dragon does better. If Selen can do around 200? No, not even close. Okay, for some reason Maxim's do one doing tons of damage, so. Something that actually did enough damage to potentially hurt us. So we're gonna use the Hidora Rocks here for the first time, which is triple attack. So it's just three normal attacks. Probably seems like it's doing the most damage, so we'll try that. As far as spells go, at least. We can toss a stronger down. This thing should drop pretty soon, but it's already taken a pretty good beating. Okay, so next turn it's gonna do that piercer attack again. Firebird, I guess. We're gonna have him just do a physical. Nope, not any better. Not any better. So. There we go. And we got the engine by blowing up the tank. And now he's going to self-destruct the castle out of spite. And we're going to stand around like this. And Selen's just gonna warp. I'm not sure why at this, like, pivotal point in the game where they've just demonstrated the, you know, the big bad for the first time, they decide this is a great time for us to throw in Bertie and Bart in the middle of this dungeon side quest. But they did. You know what? We're gonna actually... This video's been going for a while. We did two dungeons, or two sections. We're gonna save here. And we will pick back up next time. With more exciting adventures. Hopefully with more airship. There's not a whole lot of game left. So there's probably only gonna be maybe three more of these videos. If I'm remembering correctly. But yeah, hopefully you're enjoying these. If you are, give me a like and subscribe. Check out the other content on my channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments. And as always, have a good one.